खुदा तेरे है कदम में सिर सजदा करते हैं।
थैंक यू पास्टर निखिल हेल्पिंग मी एंड सपोर्टिंग मी, गॉड ब्लेस यू। द बुक ऑफ एक्सोडस चैप्टर 3 वर्स नंबर 11, Exodus chapter 3 and verse number 11.
But Moses said to God, "Who am I that I should go forward and bring the children of Israel out of Israel?"
Okay. Praise the Lord. Moses having conversation with God face to face, and Moses asking one question, a very meaningful question. You know what question he is asking to God? Who am I? In other words, he says, "Lord, what is my identity? Who am I?" And that's my topic. This morning, that we have to ask ourselves that who am I? And this is very serious and very sincere question. Maybe sometimes we forget that who am I, who we are. Having the lack of knowledge about ourselves that who we are, sometime and many times we are doing notorious things, nonsense things, because we don't know who we are. And let's jump into the Bible and we'll see who we are in Christ. Just keep it this question in your mind, in your heart, and just meditate. And when you, early in the morning, when you got up, you ask this question to yourself, who am I? And you will find all the answers in the Bible. And today, we are going to see who we are in Christ and what the Bible says about that. That what is our identity? How people are identify, how people are recognizing ourselves that who we are. Because we have our identity, Bible says that. So we have to, having very less time, so I will just try to finish three, there are many, many, many points I wrote, but at least three or four points I want to preach. Number one, 1 John chapter 3, verse number 1 and 2. 1 John chapter 3, verse number 1 and 2, there we say is that we are the children of God. Number 1. Who you are, who am I? I am a son of God. You are the daughter of God. You are the sons of God. We are the children of God. If you just read the scripture, you will understand that. See the relation with the father, between father and, you know, children. We are sons of God. We are children of God. And that's the reason, you know, Jesus taught this prayer to disciples. What he says, when you pray, say, "Our Heavenly Father." You know that prayer in Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 9? It says, when you pray, pray like that. "Our Heavenly Father." See, we have the relation with God. What? Father and son. Father and children. So think that you are a very precious the sight of God. Because we are, you are, myself, we are a children of God. And that's the great, you know, relation we have with our Heavenly Father. That we are not useless people. Let me tell you. What other people think about you, that's not a matter. But what God thinks, that doesn't matter. What the Bible says. When the people, you know, saying, telling 100 things against me, I don't care. Because I know who am I. I know what is my position in Christ. I am a son of God. Parmeshwar ka beta hoon. Aur Parmeshwar khud kehta hai ki tu mera beta hai. He himself says that you are my child. How we got this sonship, the childrenship? You know, Gospel of John chapter 1. Read that. Verse number 12. Gospel of John chapter 1. Verse number 10. How we have received this sonship in our life.
But as many as received him.
As many as received him. To whom?
Them.
Jesus Christ. Is it?
To them. Become children of God.
See, the rights become the children of God. How we receive the, how we have the sonship? Because we have received Jesus Christ in our life. And through Jesus Christ, we are the children of God. Is that clear? Through Jesus Christ, because the scripture is very clear, it says, as many as received him, to them he gave right to the children of God. Through Jesus Christ, we are the children of God. Remember these things in your mind. Then Romans chapter 8 and verse number 14 says a very different thing. Romans chapter 8, verse number 14. Those who led by the Spirit of God. See, sister.
For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are Son of God.
See. Those who led by the Spirit of God. Not according to their knowledge. Not according to their wisdom, not according to their understanding, but led by the Holy Spirit or the Spirit of God. They are the children of God. The Holy Spirit is given for us. And that the Holy Spirit, if we are led by the Holy Spirit, definitely we are a children of God. Through Jesus we receive this sonship, and those who led by Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Then Galatians chapter 4 verse number 7 says, through Jesus Christ, 4:7, Galatians 4:7.
Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then as heir of God through Christ.
Yeah, see, now you are no longer slave. You are not a slave. But through Jesus Christ, you are the children of God. You are the sons of God. If we are the sons of God, we are the children of God. Then what is our duty? What is our responsibility? Philippians chapter 2 and verse number 15. Philippians chapter 2, verse number 15.
So that
No one can criticize you.
No one can criticize you.
Live clean, innocent lives as children of God.
See, we should be blameless. We should live innocent life because we are the children of God. Think about the Jesus Christ. The many people, they tried to cut him. Jews, scribes, Pharisees. They want to find even the single mistake in his life, but they couldn't find it. Through Jesus, we have received this sonship. And the Bible says that we should live a blameless life. That Pastor Wilson is not telling. It is written in the scripture. If we are the children of God, if you think that you are the daughter of God, if you think that you are the sons of God, if you think that we are the children of God, because when the Bible says that you are a children of God, it means you are not a worldly people. Make it sure in your mind. It means you are a separated people unto God. You are not worldly people. So that the world should not come in your life, in your mind, in your thoughts, in your emotion, in your character, in your behavior. Because you are in the world, but you are not the worldly people. Of course, we are living in this world and we can see the many corruption is there. All the bad things is going on. Day by day, we can see in the television, we can read in the newspaper. No any good news, all the bad news. And we are living in such a circumstances. Remember one thing in your mind, that you are a separated people. So your life should be what? Blameless. According to the Bible. So number one, who we are? We are children of God. So walk like the children of God. Let the Heavenly Father may glorify through our life, through our character, through our behavior. When we are walking on the street, let the people may see. Let them see the Christ liveth in our life. We are children of God. Number two, Gospel of Mark chapter 16 and verse number 15. That says there that we are a messenger of Christ. Messenger of Christ. Verse 8, go and preach the gospel. Preach the gospel. See, God has separated you, chose you, select you, called you and appointed you for a very specific reason. The great commission God has given to everyone, and this is a great responsibility to go and preach the gospel. He didn't say just go and preach the story. No, he says just go and preach the gospel. In Matthew chapter 10, verse number says, what gospel we have to preach? The gospel of kingdom. Praise God, hallelujah. The gospel of kingdom. Because we are the people of kingdom. And we have the business about the kingdom. Even if you just think and look to Jesus, when he start preaching, what he preached? Matthew chapter 4 and verse number 23. Read, sister, that. Matthew chapter 4, verse number 23. In the beginning, when Jesus was start preaching, what he preached?
Jesus traveled throughout the reign of Galilee,
teaching in the synagogues and announcing the good news about the kingdom, and he healed every kind of disease.
Announcing or the preaching about the kingdom. We are the kingdom people. See, Jesus start his preaching about the kingdom. After the test, when he start his ministry, he start preaching about the kingdom. And that's we have to preach about the kingdom. Other people, they don't know about the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven. Simply they are, you know, they are living, earning money, eating, dancing, finishing their life. Even they don't know after death where they will go. Now he is coming to alert me, the first ring. Thank you, brother. God bless you. Go and preach the gospel of kingdom. Then he says, Acts chapter 20, verse number 24, the gospel of grace. Then Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 13 says, the gospel of salvation. And Colossians chapter 1, verse number 23 says, the gospel of hope, the gospel of kingdom, the gospel of grace, the gospel of salvation, and the gospel of hope. See, the people are waiting for that. They have no salvation. They have no hope. They have no grace. They have no idea about the grace. Eagerly people are waiting for that. You know, to have that salvation, they are wasting their money, they are wasting their time, working very hard, but still they have no salvation in their life. God has given this free gift. Freely we have received, freely we have to give them. The gospel of salvation is very needed now in its present condition. Because without salvation, no one will enter into the kingdom of heaven. And thank God that Jesus Christ came into this world as a savior and he saved us. That's why we are sitting here. Praise the Lord for that. That we have received the salvation through Jesus Christ. And still the people are waiting for that. We have to go and preach the gospel of salvation to them. So, we are the messenger of Christ. Then I believe there are only one point I will read, because still I have 5 minutes, isn't it? No? Number 4, Isaiah 43:21. He says there that we are worshipper. We are worshipper. Read that. Isaiah 43:21. It's very clear.
These people I have formed for myself.
Okay.
They shall declare my praise.
They shall declare my praise. The reason I live is to worship you. Nothing else. Hello, we sing that song, chorus. The reason I live is to worship you. Because Jesus is worthy for our praise. Why we are here? Why we are on this earth? Who we are? We are the worshipper. And the Bible says, Gospel of John chapter 4 verse number 23, God is seeking such a worshipper. Praise the Lord. I am not against, and we are not against the wisdom and knowledge and degree and education and all these things. No, no, no. We are not against that. Please don't misunderstand me. If God permit you, You can earn a degree like Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. You have many degrees. Have you heard the name Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar? Have a lot of degree. You cannot, if God permit you, earn. But remember, after all these things, who you are? You are a worshiper. And God is seeking such a worshiper. Still He is seeking. And you know, Psalm 96, verse number 9 says, if we are the worshiper, then it says, we have to worship in the beauty of holiness. That's our duty, that's our responsibility. In the beauty of holiness. How should we worship God? In the beauty of holiness. And then Psalm 95:6 says, we should worship with a submission. We have to submit ourselves and worship God. And the last one, Gospel of John chapter 4:24 says, with the spirit and truth. With the spirit and truth. Not just singing, not just, you know, making noise, but worshipping in the spirit and with the truth. God is seeking. Sitting here, the worshipper are sitting here in front of me. The messenger of Christ sitting in front of me. The children of God is sitting in front of me. If the people are asking who you are, you can tell them, I am a children of God. I am a messenger of Christ. I am a worshiper of God. Then another one point is there. The 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse number 70 says that I am a new creation in Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become a new. Who you are? You are a new creation. The old things are passed away. When you are in this Bible college, you are the new creation. The old habits is passed away. The old character is passed away. The old behavior is passed away. And according to the Philippians chapter 2 verse number 5, let this mind be in you. Like Jesus. So always remember, I want to encourage each and every student, when you think that you are nothing, you are good for nothing, when you think that you cannot do anything, always close your eyes, focus your mind to Jesus, and tell yourself, encourage yourself that I am a children of God. I am a messenger of Christ. I am a worshiper. I am a new creation in Jesus Christ. If you have this kind of confidence in your life, definitely you will be success in your life, in your ministry. May good God bless you. Have a blessed day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, that you have brought a good message for all of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who we are? First, we are the children of God. And second, and third,